Hello YouTube, this is Shobi Lashari, and today I am back with one real world major project having name online election system. So as you guys are already aware that I have started a series having name PHP examples, through which I am trying my best to help the beginners to enhance their programming skills or programming logics. So I hope that this project will help beginners a lot in improving their skills. So before starting our project, let me give you a short answer of a where question that where we can use this project. So this project can be used in any field where voting or polling is required. It can be used in any school for electing the class monitor, or it can also be used in any organization to elect the general secretary or secretary. It means, in short, it can be used in any field where polling is required. So let's start our project. In this project, we have two panels. One is admin panel and other is voters panel. So in admin panel, we will simply add elections, candidates, and all of the related stuff. And in voters panel, voters will simply join and give their precious vote to their desired candidate. So let me first show you admin panel. So here I'm entering my contact number, which is obviously fake. So don't try to contact me through this. ABCD. Which is my password, login. So this is our dashboard. All of your elections will appear here. So for that, first we have to add election. So I'm simply clicking on add election button. And now here you have to add election topic, number of candidates, and related stuff. So here I'm giving the election topic as class leader, and number of candidates two, means only two candidates are eligible to fight for that position, in simple words. So here I'm entering the starting date and ending date. Now this starting date and ending date is very important in this, because election will automatically start it on this starting date and will automatically end on this ending date. So I am giving starting date as today's date and ending date as tomorrow's date. Okay, so I am clicking on add select election button. After that, simply click on OK. So all of your upcoming elections or added elections will appear here. Now you can see its status from here, which is active now. Means now people can come and vote in this election. So after that, I'm simply adding candidates in this election. So for that, simply I am selecting the class leaders election, which is our topic. In this project, you can add multiple elections which can run simultaneously. That's why I have to select the particular election in which I want to add the candidates. So here I'm entering the details of first candidate, whose name is Shobi Lashari, and his photograph. After that, his details. After that, I will simply click on add candidate. Okay, so all of your candidates will appear here. So now let me add another candidate quickly, Salar Mohammed. Let me choose his photo, and after that, Salar's detail. Okay, so both of our candidates are added. Once you added the number of candidates which are equal, which you have mentioned in your add election, after that you will not be able to add any other candidate in this election. So now our elections are added and our candidates are already added. So if I click on home page, now you can see all of your elections here. After clicking on view results, we will be able to see, we will able to check their results. So before checking the checking its result, let me show you the voting area where voters will come and cast their vote. So let me first enter the voters contact number. So here I have entered some dummy voters. You can create voters can create and their account simply by clicking on create account and then giving their username, mobile number, and password. So here I have entered the voters contact number and its password. After that, I will simply click on login. Now, this is our voters panel or voters dashboard where they can cast their vote. Now, there are only one active election at the time, and this voter can vote only once in that particular election. So here I am casting my vote to Shobi Lashari. So simply I'm clicking on this button, vote. After that, okay. So now again, I will not be able to give my vote here. So it is showing that you have already voted to this person. Now, as Shoaib Lashkari's votes are greater than Salar Muhammad's vote, that's why it's showing me that he is winning, and there is some firework for making it a little bit attractive. Okay, so now I am logging out from here, and simply I am logging in through another voter. So I will add 3 votes in this. After that, we will come back to our admin panel. So here I'm giving a second vote to Mr. Salar Muhammad from here. Okay, so I have voted here. Now, as they both have equal number of votes, that's why firework is not appearing here. So it will only appear in that situation when one candidate's votes are greater than others. So I'm logging out from here, and now I am again logging in through a third voter whose account I guess is this. And again, now I am giving a vote to myself, obviously. Vote, and it is casted. Now again, now Shoaib Lashkari has 2 votes and Salar Muhammad has only 1 vote. Now let me show you their results. So here again, I am logging in our admin panel, ABCD password. So now we can see results from by clicking the view results. So here it is showing that Mr. Shoaib Lashkari is winning from Salar Muhammad. And after that, we can check the details of our voters. Here is our voter's contact number, the date on which he voted, time, and voter's IP. Voter's IP, it is showing currently a :1, but once I upload this project on my server, then I can get real IP of the voters. After that, voted to Shoaib Lashkari. So this is our simple project on online election system. I hope you liked this video and this project. So thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe my channel along with liking my video. Thank you. Thank you very much.